by little stories that, we think will really exemplify his character. For example, the way he raises us into a Filipino culture, and I don't know if you guys realize how difficult that is, being first-generation Americans. The number one rule in our household when you're growing up was no English. And in the house, as long as you're in the house, it says, my house, no English. If I hear English, we're going to put you in the corner. So what Edgar and I would do, we'd run into the basement and speak as much English as we wanted, run back upstairs, because we didn't want to speak Tagalog just to spite him. But today, we're bilingual adults, and we truly embrace our Filipino culture, and we can speak to our relatives, and it's something that we all cherish, because we can share stories with our relatives, we can understand their jokes, and go back to the Philippines, and really enjoy family that way, because he taught us to speak Tagalog.
As a part of Filipino culture, our father has taught us how to bless. So, as you guys see every Sunday after worship, so you guys see us do that often, very often after Sunday worship. And this is a gesture coming from Filipino tradition that shows that we have respect for our elders. Now, our Papa has never failed to instill this Filipino culture in our lives. Relatives that we don't see very often are very pleasantly surprised that we know how to do this, because Americanized Filipinos don't usually do this. And I cherish the fact that our father has taught us Filipino culture in all of our lives. And Filipino culture is one of the many things that he has taught us that we can take on for the rest of our lives.
Okay, so anyone who's ever heard my dad sneeze knows how loud and powerful it is. And honestly, like, in the morning, it's pretty startling. But that goes to show how we fear our dad, but we fear him because we respect him. And as stern as he can be sometimes, we all know that inside he's just a really, really big soft.
Well, the way he plays with children, when we were young and way much lighter, he would play this favorite family game, seesaw up and down. Now that he has grandchildren, just even with weaker knees, he would have them line up and would balance them on his knees and just sing seesaw up and down. It's a simple game, but it's a symbolic of him raising us and showing the world how he knows us.
So even everybody here knows that my father is a family man. You know, this is evidenced by all the different faces that come through this congregation, and especially in our household. You know, we've had many different families that my father has brought from the Philippines just to have an opportunity here in America. And you know, it's not always easy having such a huge family, as you know. It was difficult for me to try to find 18 graduation tickets and dinner reservations for all my graduations, but you know, it's definitely a struggle that I feel very fortunate to have. And the way that my father just opens up his family's doors with such welcome arms, that has really resonated with us and with the rest of my siblings. And you know, one of the things that we will take with us for the rest of our lives is the way he always says, the family that prays together stays together. One of the prayers that I still say every night that he taught me when I was just a toddler goes a little something like this. He says, thank you God for the love of families. May you continue to be with us through our laughing and crying, and may you hold our family in the palm of your hand. Papa, thank you for holding us in the palm of your hand. We love you so much. Happy Father's Day.